Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the error in a wattmeter due to the wattmeter connection or the type of wattmeter connection. So in the EDM wattmeters we are having the two types of the connections. One is the MC connection and second one is the LC connection. In the MC connection, the terminals M and the C, these are shorted, whereas in a LC connection, terminals L and C, these are the shorted. As we know, in the wattmeter, we are having the four terminals. One is the main, second one is the load, third one is the common, and V is the voltage terminal. Okay, M, L, C, V. Okay. So when M and C are shorted, then it is known as the MC connection. When L and C are shorted, then it is known as the LC connection. Okay. So here we are having the circuit diagram that shows the MC connection. Here it is the supply voltage V. Here it is a load. For simplicity, we have considered the load is resistive, right? And here it is a wattmeter. It forms the wattmeter, right? Next, for LC connection, here we are having the circuitry. In that, here it is a supply voltage V. Here it is the load resistance RL and the four terminals of the wattmeter. So this forms the wattmeter. Okay. Now we are going to discuss, due to these two connections, which errors are occurring into the wattmeter reading. As we know, the error is nothing but the difference between measured value and the true value is nothing but the error. Right. So here we have indicated the current flowing through the current coil is I1, current flowing through the potential coil is I2. Current flowing through the load is I, voltage across load is VL. In the second circuit, current flowing through the current coil is I1, current flowing through the potential coil is I2. Voltage across load is VL, current flowing through the load is I. Okay. Now, if you check in the wattmeter, right, the reading of the wattmeter, right? So here, wattmeter reading, that is nothing but the measured power. Wattmeter reading. Okay. I am writing it as a WM, that is a measured power. WM indicates the measured power. Okay. Is equal to yes, voltage across the potential coil into current flowing through the current coil. Okay. So it is voltage across potential coil into current through current coil, product of these two is nothing but the reading of the wattmeter. As here load is resistive, okay, so that's why the power factor will be unity. Okay, so that's why here it is only voltage across potential coil, current flowing through the current coil. It is like we have coil which is measuring the voltage across the load, and second one we are having the coil which is measuring the current flowing through the load. Okay, now what is the voltage across the potential coil? If you check, the potential coil is nothing but this coil. It is connected between these two terminals. First one is here, second one is here. Between these two points, what is the voltage? It is same as that of the supply voltage, right? So can we write it as, yes, is equal to V into what is the current flowing through the current coil? Current flowing through the current coil is I1, which is equal to load current, because these two are connected in series. So can we write it as a I? Yes, so into I. Okay, so wattmeter reading is nothing but the V into I. Next, what is the V? V is the supply voltage, right? Can we apply KVL to this loop? Yes, if we apply KVL to this loop, we can write V is equal to voltage across current coil plus voltage across load. Let us consider voltage across current coil as VCC. I am writing it as VCC. VCC indicates voltage across current coil. Okay. So therefore, we can write V is equal to VCC plus VL. Okay. So it is VCC plus VL into I. Right. So further, we can write it as is equal to VCC into I plus VL into I. Okay. What is VCC into I? VCC is nothing but voltage across current coil into I. I is same as that of I1, that is the current flow through the current coil. Okay. So if you check, VCC is the voltage across current coil, I is the current flowing through the current coil. So can we say that this indicates the power consumed by the current coil, PCC, that is the power consumed by the current coil, plus what is VL into I? VL is the voltage across the load, I is the current flowing through the load, okay? So it is nothing but the power consumed by the load, that is, this is actually the true power, okay? So measured power WM is equal to power consumed by the current coil plus power consumed by the load, okay? So here, can we write measured power, therefore measured power, that is a PM, is equal to power consumed by the current coil plus power consumed by the load. We can write it as a true power. P, power consumed by the load. What is the expected? The wattmeter should show the actual power consumed by the load. But whether the wattmeter is showing this power? No. In addition to this, the wattmeter is showing the power consumed by the current coil also. Are you getting the point? Okay. So therefore, error is equal to measured power minus true power is equal to measured minus true power is nothing but it is a power consumed by the current coil. Power consumed by the current coil. Is this clear? So here the error is due to the power consumed by the current coil. Okay. Whereas if we check the second circuit, in the second circuit we are having, yes, supply voltage V, voltage across load is VL, current flowing through the load is I, current flowing through the current coil is I1, okay? So now, if we check here, wattmeter reading, yes, wattmeter reading, let us consider it as a WM or you can say it as a PM also, okay? So WM is equal to voltage across potential coil into current through the current coil. Product of these two is nothing but the wattmeter reading. Okay. So if you check what is the voltage across potential coil, voltage across potential coil means potential difference between these two points. Okay. So can we say that voltage across these two points is nothing but the VL? So it is a VL into what is the current flowing through the current coil? It is a I1. Now please be careful. In this case, I1 is not equal to I. Okay. I1 is equal to I2 plus I here. Okay. So can we write it as is equal to VL into what is the I1? Can we apply KCL here? Yes, incoming current is equal to addition of the outgoing current. So I1 is equal to I2 plus I. So we can write it as I2 plus I. So it is equal to VL into I2 plus VL into I. This is the measured power, right? Again, what is the VL into I2? VL is nothing but the voltage across load, which is same as that of the voltage across the potential coil. I2 is the current flowing through the potential coil. So VL I2, can we say that is equal to voltage across potential coil into current flowing through the potential coil? So it is nothing but power consumed by the potential coil. Okay, so this is nothing but power consumed by the potential coil. So PPC, I am writing power consumed by the potential coil plus what is VL into I? It is a power consumed by the load. This is your WM, that is a measured power or the wattmeter reading. So we can replace this WM with a measured power. So PM, PM is nothing but measured power is equal to what? PPC, potential coil power, plus load power PL. Okay. But strictly speaking, this PL is nothing but actual power consumed by the load. That is nothing but the true power. Okay. So therefore, you can write PM is equal to power consumed by the potential coil plus true power. Right. So from this, we can write error. Therefore, error is equal to PM minus PT, measured power minus true power, which is equal to power consumed by the potential coil. So please try to understand. In the LC connection, the error is due to the power consumed by the potential coil. In the MC connection, the error is due to the power consumed by the current coil. They have asked the questions, right, in the previous gate examinations. In the MC connection, the error is due to the power consumed by the current coil. In the LC connection, the error is due to the power consumed by the potential coil. Right? But if you check in both the cases, the error is due to the coil which is connected to the load side. In this case, current coil is connected to the load side, potential coil is connected to the supply side. In this connection, the current coil is connected at the supply side, potential coil is connected at the load side. Okay, so here error is due to the load side coil, that is nothing but the potential coil. Here the error is due to the load side coil, that is nothing but the current coil. Okay, so this is about the error due to the wattmeter connection type. Thank you.